I'm Yulon Pineda, and I'm a volunteer here aboard the USS Hornet. I'm sitting inside the actual Apollo Command Module CM-011 that was last flown in outer space in 1966. Hang in there, because I'm going to tell you all about this historic artifact. This is the story of a spacecraft that never carried a crew, but carried us one step closer to the stars. Months before launch in Downey, California, North American Aviation had completed the construction of the Apollo Block 1 Command Module, CM-011. Unlike later modules, Block 1 was designed strictly for Earth orbit, lacking docking capabilities with the lunar module. The AS-202 was an unmanned mission, so there was no need for any crew couches. In their place was a spacecraft controller and computer. April 1966, the spacecraft components arrived at Cape Kennedy. The service module underwent propulsion system checks at Launch Complex 16. By June, the fully integrated spacecraft stood atop the Saturn 1B launch vehicle, and on July 2nd, it was erected at Launch Complex 34. Final checks were completed in the weeks leading up to launch. August 25th, 1966. At precisely 1:15 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the engines ignited. AS-202 roared to life, lifting off into the sky, piercing through the clouds just 45 minutes behind schedule. The first and second stages of the Saturn 1B performed flawlessly. The spacecraft reached an altitude of 617 miles, traveling over 5,600 miles per hour. The Service Propulsion System, SPS, fired multiple times, simulating the engine burns needed for a lunar mission. Re-entry was the mission's ultimate test. AS-202 plunged into Earth's atmosphere at a staggering 28,512 feet per second. The spacecraft briefly skipped off the atmosphere before descending again, reaching temperatures of 2,700 degrees Fahrenheit. The USS Hornet, positioned in the Pacific, led the recovery effort. However, due to a steeper-than-expected re-entry angle, the capsule splashed down 236 miles short of the target. Now that the Hornet was hours away, Air Force C-130s from the Aerospace Rescue and Recovery Service dropped rescue swimmers in the water to stabilize the floating command module. They also dropped supplies to assist with recovery operations. After nearly 10 hours in the water, the capsule was finally secured aboard the Hornet. NASA engineers inspected the spacecraft, confirming the success of the heat shield test, an essential step in ensuring astronaut safety. On September 2, 1966, the command module was offloaded in Long Beach, California for further study. 2 years later, it was repurposed for land impact testing at the Manned Spacecraft Center in Houston. These tests provided critical data for future crew safety in emergency landings. In 2004, after decades of movement, CM-011 found its final home aboard the USS Hornet Museum in the San Francisco Bay Area. The AS-202 mission was more than a test. It was a crucial stepping stone to the greatest adventure toward space travel.
Until next time, I'm Yulon Pineda. Thank you for watching, and stop by for a tour sometime.